Hi, we're Mike and Bob Bryant. We use Slinko Hyper G 17 gauge.
I like to use a hybrid. I use Lux Alu Power in my mains and Luxalon Element in my crosses.
So currently in my Clash racket, I have Alu Power in the main and Wilson Gut in the cross.
I've been with the Black Coat ever since I've been with Techni Fiber.
I use Pro Stringer Blue Steel.
Most players here will string every day. Now, if you not have a match, they'll get one or two strung with different tensions based upon the weather and conditions.
Back when I was on tour, it was every other day, at least. And for every match, I'd have three or four strung, I'd say at least.
Well, I like to have at least three fresh rackets for every match.
We restring every day. We're pretty picky. We like our tensions really dialed in. We like to know exactly what it's going to be at. So we feel that we're going to lose tension overnight. And so we want a fresh stick right in the morning. Every day for practice, we'll have a new racket. For matches, we'll have four freshies.
I like to have fresh sticks for every match. I get two strung daily. And for practice, depending on where I am, I like to see what tension I like. And then once I know, I'll get maybe one racket strung a day, but it depends on how I'm feeling with the racket.
I like to call my dad my equipment manager because he's very obsessive with the stringing. I think if it were up to me, I would probably restring my racket 2 to 3 times a week. But with my dad, he doesn't let me go onto a practice court or a match court without freshly strung rackets.
I restring a lot. You know, obviously when I'm playing matches, I'll get 2 to 3 rackets done a match for a best of 3 set match. And I like to each day have, you know, a fresh racket to practice with. It's a little more expensive to do it that way, but you know, I think it helps me get the results on court.
When it comes to restringing rackets, I usually string about 2 new ones per match. In tournaments, they switch balls every 7 to 9 games, and so I like to have a fresh racket for when the new balls come out to have a consistent, controlled, and lively response. And also, leading up to tournaments, I get multiple rackets restrung to get used to the conditions, depending on how hot it is, the humidity, and how fast the ball travels through the air. Here at these tournaments, they can be pretty expensive, about $20 to $30 a racket. Sometimes even playing in smaller events when the first round prize money is, you know, $200, sometimes the expense of stringing rackets can be more than what you make.
The trend on the tour is mostly, believe it or not, stringing in the 40s. You have some players that'll go low to mid 50s.
Yeah, so we vary our tension depending on the tournament. The climate affects how the ball travels. We string at 44 pounds, but we'll adjust that depending on if it's hot, if it's cold, and the stringer can sometimes make a difference as well.
My normal tension is 54 pounds, but depending on machines, depending on how the air pressure is, sometimes when you're in California, the air's a little thinner, so I like to go a little bit tighter with my tension. Or if you're in a really muggy area like Florida, I like to go maybe down a couple pounds. And it also depends how the weather is, if it's colder, if it's warmer. There's so many different factors where it comes to tension.
Normally my tension of choice is 23 kilos, but obviously that varies with altitude conditions, hot, cold.
My tension, it's probably a little different than most people. When I was on tour, I was up at around 68 with a poly mono and an 1820 string pattern, so it was pretty tight. Most guys didn't like that very much.
I'd say I'm probably one of the tighter stringers on tour. Does vary from tournament to tournament in, you know, more player-friendly conditions. I'm probably low 60 pounds.
So I'm stringing at 49 across the board.
And I string it at 50 pounds on average, and plus or minus 2-3 pounds, kind of depending on the conditions. Stringing is not a luxury, it's a necessity.